Now in this example, we're gonna use this dentiform, and as you can see, we have extracted here tooth number 30. So we're gonna use a clamp, we're gonna place a clamp around tooth number 31. We're gonna allow the rubber dam to seal this area between 31 and 29, and then we will also include in our isolation 29, 28, and 27. So the first thing that I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and perforate for the second molar. And then I'm gonna switch the dial, and I'm gonna jump one dot, which is the first molar, and then I'm gonna go to the second premolar, first premolar, and the canine. So I added three additional perforations. See, we have completed our isolation in a really good way, meaning that there is no tissue exposed. We don't see any pink tissue through our rubber dam, which also means no saliva contamination, no saliva coming underneath the rubber dam, no blood coming underneath the rubber dam. So no contamination of our operative field, which, as you know, it's crucial doing operative procedures. So keep in mind how easy this was just because we have a pre-printed pattern. We know exactly where to perforate. We know exactly when and where not to perforate so that we can accommodate for any missing teeth in the arch.